Well, it seems that people are living longer than before, and because of that, age-related chronic diseases are on the rise.
Local scientists are now researching ways to reverse this, and joining us in studio live to speak more about it is Michael Bollong, the associate professor for the Department of Chemistry at Scripps Research. That's a great title.
Yeah.
Thanks so much for being here. So let's talk about the research that's going on at Scripps and what's really trying to accomplish here.
Absolutely. So what we're doing at Scripps is developing new small molecule drugs that are truly regenerative medicines. These are really trying to endow human beings with the regenerative properties that are seen in lower species like amphibians. You cut an arm off a newt, it can regrow. You cut a heart off of a zebrafish, it can regrow. Why can't we do that with human cells? So we're making drugs that actually promote regenerative repair in certain organs like the lung and the heart.
Wow. That's incredible. And this is happening here in San Diego.
This is happening just down the road in San Diego.
So what therapies are currently out there that can slow disease progression or treat symptoms for age-related conditions?
Yeah, so most therapies really only slow the rate of disease progression. They only slow it down. Regenerative medicine seeks to endow those organs with a new capacity or a capacity that the organ had before it was sick, right? We lose the capacity for regenerative repair as we age. And we're really trying to endow humans with that property. And so we've done this in both the lung and in the heart.
Could you speak about some of the impacts, I guess, that having a chronic condition, you might have arthritis or vision loss, it comes with age. So what are we trying to do about this? Not much or something?
Well, that's exclusively what we work on at Scripps. We're making new medicines to treat all of these different age-related diseases. My goal in my career is to make a new regenerative medicine for all of the internal organs, whether it be making new cartilage in the knee, regenerating the heart after a heart attack, or making new lung in the context of IPF, a progressive and really terrible disease of aging.
When you bring up the lung and heart, do you mean that as you have seen that actually happen in your tests in animals? And
exactly. That's the first project that I started in my lab in collaboration with our CEO, Pete Schultz, we developed a drug that regenerates the lower airway. So it makes new lung, and it tells the stem cells in the lung to regenerate and make new tissue. And that really actually addresses the root cause of a disease called idiopathic pulmonary fibrosis, or IPF, where your lung slowly turns into scar tissue as you age. It's a very terrible way to die. So this drug actually addresses that root cause, and we think it could be extensible to other diseases of the lung. COPD, for example, kills 5% of the world's population every year. So we think it could make a big difference.
So when you were studying chemistry in high school, did you ever dream that you'd be doing something like
that? No, absolutely not.
So talk to us about clinical trials. It sounds like you're getting that way a little bit from what you're sharing.
Yes, we've already started a clinical trial for the drug that regenerates the lower lung. It's in a clinical trial in Hanover, Germany currently. That's a phase one study. That's really to look at the safety and the pharmacology of the drug. Does it go where it's supposed to go, and is it well tolerated? And that should end next year. It's ongoing currently. It started in September. But next year, we aim to transition that to a phase two study where we look at efficacy, how well the drug actually works to stop disease progression, or in our case, hopefully reverse it.
Okay. And so I know it sounds like we're in the beginning stages.
Right, well, we're doing a lot.
I say beginning because how much time do you think has to pass before we actually see you working on, let me rephrase that. When do you think this is actually going to get out on the market and it's going to be treating people real time?
Yeah, this is several years from now. As you know, clinical trials are slow. Each one, especially in disease indications like these ones, take a couple of years. So 5-6 years for IPF is a likely timeline if we can get the appropriate amount of funding to bring it across the goal line ourselves, which we aim to do. And then the others are a few years behind. We've also developed a drug that regenerates heart tissue after a heart attack. So the muscle cells of your heart, they die and they don't regrow. This drug makes that you do that, right? So you can functionally repair a heart after a heart attack.
That's amazing.
Wow.
Sounds like you're well on your way. Getting there.
Well, Michael, we do appreciate you for your time. I feel like we can talk about this for hours because this is absolutely fascinating. But thank you. Sure. And you have to keep us posted. Let us know. And because I'm like, okay, we got to get you back.
We'll see you soon.
Thank you.